So we finally got a Gen 5 compatible aftermarket frame from Nomad Defense in the way of the 9F. So I think it was about like a little over 2 years ago, probably actually 3 years ago now, the Nomad frame actually came out. It's this guy right here. I've got a couple of videos on this thing. I will leave them linked down below, but that was the first Gen 4 compatible, fully compatible with Glock parts frame that came out. And then like Shadow Systems and other companies kind of followed after them. But this frame gave you a lot of things that other frames didn't. One, it gave you some cool little ledges, gave you a little bit better of a trigger guard, and it gave you far better angles than the factory Glock frame. So a lot of people love the Glock platform because it's so durable, reliable, but they don't always like the angles. And something like this aftermarket frame fixed that, but it still gave you that factory style frame and you didn't have to make it yourself. So the Nomad frames being a factory style frame, you can see they do have the serial section down there because these are fully finished. So they are purchased just like anything else you'd have to go to the store for and fill out the paperwork. A little bit of a bummer, but you're getting a far better frame. They're performed a lot better out on the range, at least for me, than a factory Glock frame did. All right, so now that you know a little bit about the Nomad, if you wanna see those videos on the compact version, I just did the 1,000 round follow-up on that. Ton of fun out on the range. All right, so let's go ahead and drop the panties for the first time on the Nomad F, the 9F, the full size. And by drop the panties, I mean we're gonna take a good look and go over the options here and talk about what you need to complete this thing, what you're gonna need if you already have some parts, and kind of some of the compatibility between 4 or 5, because since this is compatible with Gen 5 parts, it can kind of go both ways depending on which parts you have. And we'll talk a little bit about that, and they have a really good instruction manual in here too. So let's go ahead and check this thing out right now. All right, so let's take a good up close look and check out what we're gonna get with the Nomad 9F here. So I don't think I've mentioned this yet. So Nomad Defense did send this and the parts kit out to the channel. They sent out the compact frame as well a couple years ago. They've been very cool to the channel. So just so you guys understand, I do know them and they do send stuff in for me to test out. So let's go ahead and get into this. We're gonna check this frame out. We're gonna kinda take a look at the compacts. You'll have an idea of how this could basically look in the shrunken down version. And then we'll take a good look with a Gen 5 slide on there and compare it to a factory Gen 5 frame. So I'm gonna pull this stuff out of the box here because it's white. It's gonna be super blown here on camera. I'll pull this out and we're gonna get rid of the box and just go over this stuff very quickly here. So a couple things you're really gonna wanna pay attention to is the information you get with this. You're gonna have basic information here as far as the pins and the back straps and how to change the back straps on there. Super easy, just follow the directions on there. And then this one, so say you know nothing about Glocks, this is the sheet you wanna pay attention to because it gives you all of the different generations of parts you can use and whether they're gonna be compatible. And there's a couple of side notes down here that you've got to pay attention to. The biggest thing you need to understand is this and new, you know, Gen 5, 19, 17, all that stuff is based on the 19 locking block, whether it's a 19 or a 17. Since this Nomad 9 is Gen 5 compatible, you've got to run a 19 locking block and you have to run a Gen 5 17 barrel. You cannot run a previous generation barrel because it is a different locking block for those. 19 locking block, Gen 5 barrels only. Just so you guys understand that. Now we're gonna be good to go. So let's talk about what we get in here. We're gonna get two different back straps. One is on. This one that's off is a much more kind of 1911-esque of a, you know, flatter profile. And the one that's actually on here is more of the SIG kind of grip angle. So we're gonna talk about what this frame is, and then I'm gonna bring in a Gen 5 17 frame and we're going to kind of compare it. So with the Nomad frame, you're gonna get a completed frame. So much like the factory one, your rails, everything is done. It's serialized, you're good to go. You don't have to worry about milling, drilling, any problems like that. Just slap on good parts and you're gonna be good to go. As far as our texture, got a really nice kind of rough cotton candy texture like that. Not overly grip, not overly like gonna tear your hand up, but very grippy. Back strap's gonna be all the way around. And then kind of on the front right there, you just got some lines and you got a nice little kind of ledge right there, which is really gonna grab your pinky and help keep you in a good grip position. And if you've got monster hands, it's gonna help protect your pinky from getting pinched when you do mag exchanges. We are gonna have a nice little bevel in there as far as the magwell goes. It's gonna help you do those magazine exchanges, which is definitely cool. And I know they are coming out with the magwell and backstrap combo very soon. It's just still in development. So coming up from there, you're gonna have a much bigger beaver tail right there. You can see how much it gets up on the web of my palm. You're gonna have the ability to run Gen 4 or Gen 5 slide stop slide release. You can see you have those kind of barriers right there. And what those are for is as your hand is in here, that kind of keeps you from activating that slide stop slide release. So you can run either one you want. Moving forward from there, much better trigger guard here than the factory Glock frames, which we'll take a look at in a second. Gives you a little bit more room if you've got those big hot dog fingers, but it's very, very much better of a cleaner design. A little bit of an undercut right there. And it just feels better than the factory one to me because it doesn't have that gnarly hard edge up in the front. Going forward, you can see two pin design there. You've got your ledges, which Nomad's kind of known for. Awesome, they got that same texture in there and you can really just get your thumb in there and control that recoil impulse. Moving forward, get a little bit of information right there on the side of the frame. Single slot for the pick rail, your serial number spot, and then the Nomad defense numbers and letters right there, which is very tastefully done. So that in a nutshell is what you're gonna get with the frame. So compatible Gen 4, Gen 5. If you're gonna use the Gen 5 trigger, then you've gotta use, or if you're gonna use a Gen 5 slide stop slide release, then you've gotta use a Gen 5 trigger. You have to use the Gen 5 trigger block, or you have to go Gen 4, Gen 3 parts kit. Up to you, but remember, gotta be 19 locking block and Gen 5 17 barrels only. So just remember that. I know I've kind of harped on that a little bit. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at the parts kit. So they sent the parts kit out as well. The parts kit is going to have everything you need. It's going to have your locking block, trigger housing group, trigger bar, everything you need to actually finish off the frame, your mag release, all the good stuff you're going to need to get in there. It will come with a Gen 3, 4 style slide stop slide release. It does not come with a Gen 5 version because that kit is meant to be used with the compact and this new full size as well. So let's talk about the differences in the frame as compared to a Glock, and we'll compare it to that. So the biggest thing is going to be, get these flat here so you can see, is going to be that grip angle. So you can see that protrusion, you know, the Glock hump down there on the bottom. That's the biggest thing that people kind of complain about. People do backstrap reductions, people do stipple work, they try to flatten that out. That's just something that's kind of known for. And then you talk about the trigger guards right there. You can see huge difference in the profile of the trigger guard. And these things just, you know, it takes up a lot of space where you could have a little bit cleaner of an angle right there. As on the Nomad, pretty much forward from there, it's going to be the same kind of style rail and all that good stuff, but you are getting a better angle and you're definitely getting, let's put these as close as we can here, try to get pin to pin on the side right here, and you can see you're getting a pretty decent amount more when it comes to a little bit of a beaver tail right there, which is going to help you control that recoil impulse out on the range. As far as the plans for this thing, I think I'm going to be running, I'm gonna run this one on it. My Gen 5 17 MOS slide, give you guys a really good look at kind of how that thing looks and how that could be if you wanna build one with a stock slide, but I think that's pretty much how I'm going to run that one. And then obviously a fully completed one. It's going to look something like this, but you can see, obviously this is the compact version, but gives you a really good idea of what it could look like finished. Then as you can see on this one, even though it's a Gen 4 lower, I am running the Gen 5 45 MOS slide on there. No problems at all. Love this thing. This is what I ran on that updated video. I'll leave that link down below. And then I'll throw all this stuff in the build list down there with some options on what you can or can't do, should you guys be interested. So let's go ahead and talk about price, what else you're going to need to finish this thing out, and then some of the other options you can go if you are looking at the Nomad defense setup. All right, so that is just good stuff. So I had really good luck with the compact frame that Nomad had sent me a couple of years ago. The grip angle on that thing just really kind of fits the ergonomics of how my wrists and hands want to be on the pistol when I'm out there using this thing on the range. I'm really hoping that the 9F kind of falls through with that, which it pretty much should because it's the same frame. basically same angles, just a little bit longer. I know they do have some other stuff coming out. I think they're going to have the same kind of version of a magwell coming out real soon. All that stuff is just still in production. So let's go ahead and get into the cost of that actual setup right there. So the frame itself is like 200 bucks. So it's like right there at that $200 mark. And like I said, these are serialized, fully completed. You don't have to drill anything, finish anything out. The rails are internally into the frame. So it's really just like a Glock frame, but it gives you options that the Glock factory frames don't, or just flat out can't. Because if you take a good look at those little ledges right here, you don't have enough meat on the Glock frame to really put a ledge like that in there. So there are some level ups and some positives. And then having the ability to go between kind of that more SIG angle, which is what I really like on this, or even a little bit flatter if you want more of a 1911 with those changeable back straps, is definitely pretty cool. So if you want their parts kit, their kit comes Gen 4, Gen 5. So you can run either one, but you've got to kind of know which parts you can use. Because if you use a Gen 5 slide stop, you got to use a Gen 5 slide, where you can use a Gen 4 slide stop with a Gen 5 slide. So you got to kind of know a little bit, but that little guide they give you is really good, at least basically to get you going. So their parts kit, which will cover 4 and 5, is going to give you a like a $90 price tag, which isn't bad because that comes with the locking block, which you're gonna need, and everything to finish out your frame. Other than that, you're gonna need a slide, you're gonna need a barrel, sights, and then of course all the internal parts for the slide. And I'll have all of that stuff at the build list and a couple different options so you can check them out depending on what you want to go with as far as a slide or anything else, or whether you want a factory slide. And a lot of that's just really gonna be personal preference. Or you can just build it out how you want with custom triggers and all that stuff, because the Nomad kit is very kind of stock-esque. Now, I know somebody's gonna say, well, buying a factory Gen 5 17, like my Gen 5 17 MOS right there, is going to be cheaper. Yes, that may be, depending on if you have parts laying around or not, but the second you send this frame out for stippling or anything like that, your price just went way up. So it really depends on how you wanna start. Do you wanna start with a factory frame? Do you wanna start with an aftermarket frame? Do you have parts? Do you not have parts? Do you wanna build from the ground up, or do you want, you know, a straight stock or 17 MOS like this and then just put whatever optic you want on it? And that's really, again, gonna be one of those personal preference things. But that Nomad frame, like I said, gives you things that this frame just can't. So I will have the full range video on that done real soon. I got to get it out there and get a couple hundred rounds through it so I can really tell you guys if there are going to be any issues, which I doubt there are, because like I said, my experience with the compact frame has just been absolutely great. Run in Gen 4, and as you can see, that's a Gen 5 45 MOS slide on there. So it's a runner, it's great, it's got good angles, but I've still got to do that due diligence of getting a couple hundred rounds through it. So we're gonna know should a problem arise, which like I said, really doubt there's gonna be one. So if you guys wanna get started on getting that thing together, the build list is down below. Make sure you guys get subbed up, get belled up. Turn those notifications down there to all on so you know when the videos come out. You guys get out there on the range, have some fun, and remember, if you stay ready, you ain't gotta get ready. I will see you guys on the next one.